Hi, I'm Analytical, the sickeningly entertaining and educational coding queen. And apparently the only way I know how to code is by mindlessly copying and pasting. So today we're gonna build a really quick, really fun website that is made exclusively by copying and pasting code to show you how to not mindlessly copy and paste code and learn a little bit about web development along the way. So let's go into CodePen real quick because this is where we're gonna have all of our stuff living, and this is kind of like a 10-minute challenge, 15-minute challenge. Not really because it's a challenge, but because I wanna get some food. Okay, so we're gonna make a new pen, and this is where we're gonna start off. So basically, websites are made of HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and writing it all can be kind of a pain. So why not find some already existing JavaScript, already existing HTML, and already existing CSS to use for this? Okay, so I'm gonna try to exclusively use copying and pasting. So if you don't know how to copy and paste, the commands are Command C and Command V, and I believe it is Control C and Control V on Windows. And you really wanna make sure you don't use the cut command because that could be not good. If you use Command X or Control X, no. We wanna make sure that the content does not disappear. So, you know, those are basic commands that might be a little hard for some of you following along. I know these are some really difficult commands. Okay, so basically I thought it might be fun to make a little website that pops up a message saying when Drag Race is on or if it's on right now. I guess I don't really want to pop up. I just wanted to kind of say Drag Race is on right now. I think the first thing we should search is for an HTML CSS pretty text example that we can pull from that and have that be what our message is gonna look like. So let's see, HTML CSS pretty text examples. So 25 creative typography snippets, okay. And these are all done in CodePen, so that's actually really nice because we're already working with CodePen. CodePen is just a great way to try out a bit of HTML, CSS, and not have to like set up a whole website for it, and you can run it in these little embedded windows. Okay, so let's say result, or we can click edit on CodePen. And what is this? Okay, this is like looks like a little bit too many layers. I want something that's just gonna be, we can put text into it and then get it out. Okay, I actually like this knockout text, and I've actually played around with stuff like this before. So let's see what they're doing. Okay, so this is all CSS and HTML, so that's great. Okay, so we're gonna copy this in, paste it there, and then let's paste this in. Let's see how this is gonna look so far. Okay, great. So we've already got this kind of lined up. And one thing is, you don't wanna mindlessly copy and paste code because you wanna understand what you've got. So we just have a div, which has, I guess this is a link. So like cool stuff, visit my site. So maybe instead of that, well, I guess I'll keep it like that. Maybe I'll delete this for like, you know, a more PG-13 audience, I don't know. And instead of linking to that website, let's link to my YouTube channel instead. And I'm gonna copy that link in, paste it right here. You know, only copying and pasting today. I think that's very important. And then here they're using this background image. I guess it's like a NASA moon thing. So maybe let's see if we can find like a good Drag Race image. So RuPaul's Drag Race season 12 cast. And let's just look for a photo. Ooh. I'm just gonna grab this big photo. Thank you, EW. Is this not a photo? Gotta find a photo. Okay, maybe you can just do copy image address. Sure, we'll go with that. You know, pasting it in. It got a little misaligned, so let's look at CSS background examples to see if we can find something that will make it like a little bit easier so we don't have to have it all scaled out. Maybe we can shrink it down a little bit in there. So CSS background image. And for those of you watching at home, I understand some of this. I've played around with CSS before, a bit of HTML before, and even worked with it in my jobs, but I haven't really thought about a lot of this going in. So we're in this together, looking through this example, seeing what we can learn quickly, copying and pasting and learning at the same time. So they use this image here. Wish there were more. Okay, so here's information on like how we can size this. So maybe let's do background position center, copy that in. Okay, so that's changing it a little bit. And then a height. I guess, did they specify a height? They specified a width, 500 pixels. Okay, so I think we just have Britta's face. Can we change these numbers? So now we need to get new numbers for these that are gonna work a little bit better. Oh, maybe I'll try copying 50 pixels to see how that works. So I don't have to, you know, don't wanna write anything. Okay, that made it really small. So I guess let's undo that. I think we want it to be bigger. You know, I think that's fine for now. And let's actually make some more text in here. I'm just gonna throw this link in here so we have something so we can see a little bit more of this text. You know, instead of this, I think maybe a patterned image would be better. That way it's kind of not all over the place. Let's just search for like purple pattern repeatable. I don't know, we can find a nice image to use for this. Okay, sure. Let's go for this one. Copy image address. Okay, this is looking better. And now we have the text in there. So now what we need to do is update this text based on some JavaScript. So I'm just gonna Google how to do that. Update text with JavaScript. And change the text of a span element in JavaScript. Okay, so we have a div, and divs and spans are kind of the same, so we can probably make this work. Okay, document.getElement, myspan.textContent equals new text. Okay, so we're gonna copy that in, and we need to give our, not, we have to give our div this ID of span. So it actually is this class knockout, and we can give it an ID myspan. HTML elements are just a way to structure your page and use IDs and classes to style them and interact with them in JavaScript. An ID, you can only have one per page, and a class, you can have multiple. So we can have multiple knockout elements, so we can only have one of myspan. So now we're setting it with new text, so we can even throw like whatever we want in here. And it should work correctly, although we have this quote, so we're gonna have to remove that so we don't have any issues. So everything we can throw in here is gonna work. And we might have some issues with the width, but we're just playing around with it to get something going. So I'll just undo this so we have new text in there. All right, now we wanna update this text based on the date. So let's see, let's search JavaScript update text based on date every second, maybe. We wanna kind of have it constantly be checking so you don't have to reload the website to see is RuPaul's Drag Race on, you just kind of want it to always update continuously. How to update the time regularly. Okay, so there's update clock, so there's, they get a date object, they have all the months, I guess. Then, basically they're getting the time. Okay, so they kind of left out parts of this example, but that's okay. And then they're joining some of these things together. Okay, so I like this, and it's also, we're getting the set time out in here. So I'm gonna copy this in, and we're gonna have to change some stuff. We're gonna have to get a little bit of other stuff in here, but I think we'll be able to start making this work. And I'll also make this bigger. I don't think we need the CSS for now, and our HTML is pretty good too. So we focus purely on the JavaScript. So instead of updating this time element, let's instead update the myspan. So I'll copy this in. Ooh, we are running out of screen space here. What is this? There's a little error. Can't set property inner HTML of null. Okay, that's fine, because we're gonna comment that out. Okay, get element by D, myspan equals, and let's just set it. I know I told you not to use the cut command, but I just did it. Oh. Okay, I'm gonna put that on a new line, comment it out. Comments are fine without copying and pasting, right? Okay, let's see what's happening over here. I guess, is it gonna update every minute? No, it'll update every second. Let's read the code that I copied and pasted. You know, because we are not mindlessly copying and pasting code. Okay, so here it's getting minutes, and why don't we look up get the seconds for JavaScript? So JavaScript date get seconds. Okay, it looks like it's just get seconds. And we could have written that out, but why not copy and paste it to get a little wild? Do I have an error? Unexpected token, comma. Okay, let's see what I do. Oh, I see. I guess there's a little comma in there. Maybe I hit it by accident, but okay, we're using the delete key as well in this tutorial. We are good now. This is updating every single second. So we're doing pretty well. Now, I think what we want to do is get the day of the week based. We want to get the day of the week from the date and then do an if statement comparing if that day of the week is Friday, Drag Race is on that day. And then I think we can say if Drag Race is on, say yes, Drag Race is on. And if it's not, you can watch my tutorials instead. So what a win. You get drag every day of the week you want it. Okay. JavaScript, get day of week. Get day of week from date. And you can make a typo when you're searching. Okay, get day. Oh, cool. Okay, so get day. And I guess it said which day is Friday. Okay, Friday is 6. Wait, no, 5 is... Friday is 5. Gotta read, okay. Date, okay, so they made a new date and they're doing get day. Okay, so let's get rid of some of this. So we don't even need, we don't need this date object. And delete that. We just wanna do now.getDay. So instead of time, this is actually just gonna be day. So I'll copy that in over there. And I'll copy day here. Am I cheating by copying and pasting all the stuff in here? No. I'm make up the rules for this challenge, so it's gonna be whatever I want it to be. So now the inner content is gonna be the day. And let's just delete some of this other stuff because we don't need it. It's always good to clean up some of the stuff you take. Okay, so it is day 0. And what day of the week is that? Sunday, okay, it's Sunday. And hopefully this content is out to you by day number 1 or day number 2, but we'll see. Okay, and we're totally in the home stretch. Now we wanna get an if statement. If day equals 5, then we'll print our good message, and if it's not, we'll print our watch my other stuff instead. Okay, so I'm just gonna do JavaScript if statement, and I'll do numbers even. That way we'll even have less work to do. Okay, well, not no, but sure, okay. If time is less than 20, so we actually want if day, can I copy this? Okay, I'm just gonna copy two equal signs. Equals equals, and day equals, oh, and then here's the 5 for Friday. You know me, mindlessly copying and pasting code. Okay. Oh, good day, and then instead of that, we can actually copy this part over here. Day equals 5, good day, otherwise it'll print the number. So we know it's gonna print that number. We actually want an else statement in here. Is there an else? Yes, okay, good. How was I gonna do the else if I couldn't copy and paste it, you know? Otherwise, we'll put it in here. This is not gonna do anything right now, but maybe we can say, I'll set this to 0 just so we can have a kind of way we can see if it's gonna change based on that. So, okay, so this says good day. So let's change that back. We can undo, that's another one. Command Z or Control Z on Windows to undo, you know, might be good, especially if you're doing a lot of copy and pasting. You wanna make sure you can get to the original state of that copy paste. This other one's just gonna print day. I guess what do we want it to print out? Let's get our quotes in here at least. And one semicolon should be enough. And, oh, maybe we can pull from here because it said, Lytical, visit my site. Sure, you know? We're just trying to get any kind of text that we can copy and paste. Lytical, visit my site. Lytical, visit my site. Okay. And then, I don't know, should I just search when is Drag Race on? I'll copy this. I'll throw it in here. Drag Race season 12 will air. And now we can open this in full page mode. Lytical, visit my site. And can I click this? I should be able to click. I should have been able to click this still. Oh, I see. Let's move this span onto this link instead. That way it stays a link. Right now we're setting the inner text of my span, which is this whole link and all this stuff. But we just want to set the inner text of the link and then we'll be able to keep the link the whole time. And we can even clear this out because we don't need that anymore. Lytical, visit my site. And then if we click this, you'll go to my YouTube channel. Go, don't forget to like, subscribe, ring the bell. I'll remind you in a minute, don't you worry. And then if we were on a Friday, it would say, Drag Race will air today. Where is that? It will say Drag Race Season 12 will air. So we were able to make a full website just copying and pasting code and combining lots of different components. The reason I wanted to make this video is because I sent out a tweet saying coding is actually 30% of your time copying and pasting code, 30% of your time drinking coffee, 30% of your time debugging, 9% like finding a lost semicolon, and then 1% actual coding. This is not an original joke. This is not our original thought. I didn't even think it was that funny. Yet a lot of people took this and saw, oh, Anna's saying this thing. It must be a woman and it must be someone who is incompetent or isn't able to think clearly or isn't able to copy and paste code smartly. People are even saying I work for Google, but this is all opinions are all of my own thoughts. So don't get it twisted. People were saying to interview at Google, to get a job at Google, you have to be really smart. There's a rigorous interview process. And it seems like they must have wanted to finish saying, Anna must be smart. Anna must know what they're talking about or she's talking about. And no, they finished that sentence by saying, oh no, Anna's a diversity hire. She got hired because she's a drag queen. And that literally doesn't make any sense because I didn't even start doing drag until I worked at Google. So all these nincompoops are making stuff up, not using logic, and are just trying to put women and other people down. And I am not here for this. No, you are not a diversity hire. No, you are not mindlessly copying and pasting code. No, you are valued. I want people like you watching this video. I want people like you on my team and people like you to work with. And yes, it is totally okay to copy and paste code. That's what Stack Overflow is for. That's what documentation is for. And you know what? Spend 30% of your time going on a coffee break. Go with your coworkers. Go with people on different teams and learn about what they're working on. Learn about different ways to do what you're doing and do it better. I want tech to be a community where you can feel safe to be yourself and to express yourself and make stupid jokes about code and shape the future by building all kinds of different technology. So I will end on that note. If you like this video, leave a like on the video, comment, subscribe, ring the bell, make your own website that's just done by copying and pasting websites to show the trolls who are the true bosses and who are the true coding queens. All right, that is all. I'll have some amazing new content coming out soon, but I really think it was important to get this video out to you all. So thank you and have a fabulous week.